All right, we're all situated. Ready to go. Now, it's time for freaking food! Ah! What is up, guys and gals? I am back with another vlog. For this one, as I was editing, I realized I accidentally deleted the intro clip that I recorded the day I was starting the trip. Story of my life, technical difficulties all the time. I wanted to show you how I go about prepping for a trip and packing my bags, and show you the crazy travel day that I had ahead of me before going to Maine to visit my grandpa. So, let's jump back in time. Alright, so I am all showered, freshened up. Now I just got to pack everything in my suitcase. So I laid everything out here and I'm gonna go through, sort everything, load it up, and kind of narrow down more of the stuff I wanna bring. I always lay out the things that I think I want or need, and then I kind of reduce that down to even less items because I always end up overpacking, but let's be honest, who doesn't? So yeah, let's get started. I've got my toiletry bag here, pants, sweatshirt, socks and underwear, the two pairs of shoes I want to bring, those are all shirts, pajamas, one beanie, one scarf, makeup bag, the clothes are all going to go in here. Chargers and wires, it's all gonna go in there with my other camera stuff. I may or may not bring that and slide it flat back there in that compartment. But yeah, so I am now going to go through all of this and see what I narrow it down to what I really wanna bring. Once I have this all situated in the suitcase, I will show you guys what it looks like. Let's see if I will have to sit on it to close it. Yes, I'm bringing a hair straightener, but that's because I want to have straight hair while I'm up there. So I'm going to narrow it down even more. I think what I'm going to do is just bring the leggings I'm wearing, one extra pair that's warmer, one pair of jeans, and these thinner ones I'm gonna put to the side. So I'm gonna stick these in my packing cube. I have Eagle Creek packing cubes, a set of three, and they come in three different sizes. I use the smaller one for like socks and underwear. Jeans, I tend to just sit flat at the bottom. Same with the leggings. I do also like to roll my clothes, but I tend to do that with the shirts primarily because they're smaller. The jeans are a lot thicker and bulkier. I'm going to bring this shirt because it's thin and it allows me to layer, because that's going to be a big thing. So layering to stay warm. I wanted to bring one like nice sweater, so decided yet. I want that one or one of my green ones. I have two of these, so I figured just pick the color that I want to bring. I'm trying to bring a couple different light shirts that I can layer. I keep getting out of the frame when I sit up. wanted to bring like a nice warm pajama outfit. I'm gonna take this one, leave this one. And then I'm just gonna pick the sweater I wanna bring. I think I'm gonna bring the green one. This. See, this is exactly what I mean. I can't always fit everything. So I'm either gonna have to downsize or squish everything in here. So let's see what happens. So one bad thing about packing to go somewhere cold is that you have to bring thicker, warmer clothes and they take up so much more space. Is it gonna work? So I have an idea. Okay, one sec.
I have to continue with my phone because all of my memory cards are being weird right now and I'm having technical difficulties and I don't have the time to try and figure it out. So, got my suitcase packed, putting the last few things in my camera bag, and then I am good to go. So I got my charging carrying case in here. I just gotta put this away, but when I get to the airport, I might carry it around. I don't know, we'll see how I feel. And yeah. Just gotta close it up. Got my new Flintstones on. Super comfy. Alright, I am all packed and ready to go. Just waiting for my sister to get here because she's gonna drop us off at the airport so I don't have to pay for parking, which is very, very nice and convenient. I am very excited. We are going up to just visit our grandpa and spend some time up there, and obviously we're gonna try to do some outdoor adventures and hiking if it's not too cold, but it is supposed to snow. I really wanna see snow. I haven't seen it in years, so we'll see what happens. Fingers crossed. Yeah, so I am going to go brush my teeth and then we will be heading out. We're gonna check the lines and see if we have time to get food. We have like 2 hours. I'm really hungry. I decided to get in line because they looked really long and some of the sections are really long, but I figured we can get food once we get past security, just to be safe. We have like 2 hours before the flight. It is very busy at the airport today, like wow. Are you excited for the trip?
Yeah.
So when we get there, we also have to drive up to Maine from Boston. It's gonna be like 5 hours. Yeah. But I got a rental car, and so that'll be fun getting to drive a brand new car. So it's gonna be a long day. Quest for food. I'm really hungry, so we're going to the other terminal because we have time. I really want empanadas and some coffee, so that's what we're doing. So I made a rookie mistake, and I also didn't know that they changed how the trams work, and we went to go to the other side to get food, and when you got onto that other tram, or when you came back from the tram we were on, you had to get off and exit and go out of security. So now we're back in security line. We should be okay on time, but I'm just frustrated because I'm really hungry, but it's all good. I'll eventually get a snack or some sort of food, so.
All right, let's try this again. Right now we're waiting to see if we are going to make it on the flight since we are flying standby. So let's see, the flight is supposed to be full. We got like boots to the seats. All right, so we made it to Boston. So now, finally, I want to try to get some food if there's places open here, and then we got to go pick up the rental car. I'm already really cold. I put my other jacket on. Just made it to the rental car center. It's kind of hectic trying to get out of that place in here, so I didn't really film all of that. And also it's cold. I don't feel like having my phone out and my hands out. On the way to pick it up right now, we're getting a blue Kia Forte. Should be interesting. And then we gotta drive like 5 hours. All right, get in. We made it. Oh yeah. Woo! Get to drive a fancy new car. All right, we're all situated. Ready to go. Now, it's time for freaking food. Dinner time. Burger King. I honestly hate fast food. I never eat fast food, but I'm so hungry right now. And I just want to get there. So, getting Burger King.
One eternity later.
Oh my god, we made it. How do you feel?
Tired.
Yeah, I'm exhausted. My leg is killing me. We just got to my grandparents' house and we're gonna go inside now and warm up. Also, check this out. It's 18 degrees. What the frick? So cold. All right, guys, so I am here. We made it safely. I can relax now. My brother and I came up here to spend some time with our grandpa and visit, and like I said earlier, probably do some hiking and exploring depending on how the weather is. Oh my god, that was such a long day of travel. Oh my goodness. It doesn't always take that long to get here, but the method that we chose with using buddy passes, we had to fly into Boston and then drive because the bus system stopped running at 3 and it was a whole thing. But we made it, we're here. Time to change into pajamas, get comfy, and go to sleep. Oh my goodness. I hope you guys enjoyed this vlog. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Make sure to subscribe to my channel to stay up to date with all of my videos I post every week. Make sure to follow me over on Instagram and Twitter at CastTheNomad, and I will see you in the next vlog.